大家好 ，Hello everyone, welcome to this elementary Mandarin class. My name is Sisi, 我是 Sisi 老师。Today's lesson, we will talk about pivotal sentence. The predicate of pivotal sentence is made up of two verbal phrases. The object of the first verb is also the subject of the second verb. The first verb in a pivotal sentence should be a verb with the meaning of making or ordering somebody to do something, such as 叫, to ask, 让, to let, 请, to ask or to invite. Let's have a look at some examples. 叫, to ask, it often appears in an oral Mandarin.
妈妈叫我去买一些水果。
我 is the object of 叫。It is also the subject of 去买一些水果。
妈妈叫我去买一些水果。妈妈叫我去买一些水果。
我叫人去看看。人 person, people. In this sentence, it means somebody.
我叫人去看看。我叫人去看看。
朋友叫我去踢足球。
朋友叫我去踢足球。
让 means to let, allow.
你让我想一想。
我 is the object of 让。It is also the subject of 想一想。
你让我想一想。
我让女儿去图书馆看书。
我让女儿去图书馆看书。
妈妈不让爸爸喝咖啡。
妈妈不让爸爸喝咖啡。
Both 请 and 让 have the meaning of ask somebody to do something. 请 used in a formal situation and sounds polite.
我请经理帮助你。
经理 manager,
经理
帮助 to help,
帮助。
经理 is the object of 请。It is also the subject of 帮助你。
我请经理帮助你。
我请经理帮助你。
我们请老师说一下明天的考试。
说 means to say, to talk. 考试 exam, test.
考试。我们请老师说一下明天的考试。
We ask teacher to talk about tomorrow's exam.
我们请老师说一下明天的考试。
请 also have the meaning of invite.
今天晚上我请朋友吃饭。
This evening, I invite my friends to have dinner.
今天晚上我请朋友吃饭。
It worth noting that there is a cultural difference here. In Chinese, when you say 请 as invite, for example,
我请你吃饭。
In a restaurant setting, it means I will pay for the bill. The same,
我请你喝咖啡。
Literally means I invite you to have a coffee.In Chinese, it actually means I will buy you a coffee.
我请你喝咖啡。
我请你看电影。I invite you to watch a movie and I will pay for the tickets. 我请你看电影。
Alright, that's all for today's lesson. Hope you learn a lot from this video. If you think it's helpful, please subscribe. You can also find Mandarin Elementary Level and many other videos in the playlist on my channel. Let me know if you have any questions.
我是 Sisi 老师 See you soon in next lesson. 谢谢，再见，拜拜。